Derek Tony, VarsitySportsNetwork.com. We're here at Edmondson High School where the Red Storm basketball team are a step closer, big step closer, to going to the city title game. They win 73-67 over Lake Clifton in a good old-fashioned east-west battle in Baltimore City. I'm with Coach Darnell Dantzler. And Coach, you know, I was sitting there watching you in that fourth, most of the second half, and you pretty calm. I don't know if it's because of the tech or whatever, but you're sitting on the bench. The game is close. I'm like, I don't know what you're thinking. I don't know if you're waiting for the proverbial of a shoe to drop, or you just had that much confidence in your team. But I mean, just talk about the win. But you know, talk about how proud you're proud of this team to find a way to beat like tonight, especially in that fourth quarter crunch time.
I'm proud of them. The kids, they played as hard. They played their heart out. Mm-hmm. I mean, they was diving on the floor, rebounding the ball, getting their hands on loose balls. They did all the little intangible things that mm-hmm. it did, that it took to win a basketball game. I mean, like I told them, your offense might not be there all the time, mm-hmm. but your defense has to be there. I mean, my hat goes off to the kids. They took, you know, they was down early. They fought through it. They went through the adversity. Mm-hmm. And they came back and bounced back, played hard, good defense mm-hmm. in the third or fourth quarter. I made a couple of adjustments. Second half, I went to a 1-3-1 to try, because they were shooting the ball well in the first half.
Right.
So I made some adjustments. That's all about adjustments.
Mm-hmm.
So I made some adjustments going into the second half. Mm-hmm. Came out, gave them a different look mm-hmm. as far as defense. The kids executed on my defensive plan, shared the ball on offense, and we was fortunate to come out with the win.
Right. Talk about Marcus Hocker. Best game of the season for him?
Hey, big talent. Mm-hmm. You know, he's been playing good all season. Mm-hmm. I mean, double-double guy. He does everything. For him to be so big, he can actually handle the ball. Mm-hmm. He can shoot from the perimeter. Mm-hmm. He's actually too unselfish. I mm-hmm. try to tell him, he's my playmaker, and mm-hmm. I need him to do more things. But he does it all. He did well on the defensive end. Mm-hmm. He also handles the ball. He can see he's long, so he sees over top of the double teams. He's a big talent, so my hat goes off to him. He played right well today.
Yeah, talk about some other kids who played well for you tonight, just came up big. I thought 22 coming off the bench gave you some real quality.
Yeah, Tony, that's my little tugboat right there. I mean, he has the heart of a lion. He come in whenever his number's called, he come in and plays mm-hmm. hard. Keith Bolden played extremely well. He took a couple of bad shots down the stretch mm-hmm. that I wanted to beat him up for.
Right.
But, you know, overall game, he played well. Trayshawn played a good on the defensive end. Mm-hmm. And my 10th grader, Iante, he had some big shots, some big threes early in the first half. Hit a couple of shots in the second half. Got his hands on some steals. Got a layup. Mm-hmm. So it's an all-around team effort. And that's what I told the kids downstairs. I can point to each one of them and tell them something they did good mm-hmm. on the offensive and defensive end. My anchor in the hole, Barry, played extremely well on the defensive end. He was banged up, but he left it all out there. And that's all I can ask for the kids, is to leave it all out on the floor. So I'm just happy that we was fortunate to come out with the win.
All season when we talked, you know, you kind of like being the underdog, kind of being the forgotten team. But as you guys got win after win after win, people started noticing you. But your team has kept their heads about them.
And that's what it is. I told them just stay humble. From day one, we wasn't ranked. I told them don't worry about it. I knew some of the pieces that we had brought in, to add with the pieces that the kid that we had that's been in our program for 4 years. I saw over the summer how they was gelling. So I told them just be humble. We're gonna take it every one game at a time. We're not worrying about the rankings. We're not worrying about the city championship. We're not worrying about the state. We just want to improve game after game and take it one day at a time. The kids been listening. They've been doing. They've been excelling in the classroom. That's another thing that I really, really want to give them kudos for, because all I've been excelling in the classroom, we pretty much as a team has a 3.0. So they're doing it in the classroom, and they've been fortunate to do it on the basketball court as well. So they're student athletes, and I like it because they're doing it on both ends. So starting off, like I said, we had no expectations. Mm-hmm. Me as a coach and my coaching staff, we always have high expectations. Mm-hmm. We want to win every game, mm-hmm. but we also got to be realistic mm-hmm. of how it is. Baltimore City basketball is a normal grind, mm-hmm. so we got to take it game after game. Mm-hmm. The late team up there was a good team. They only lost two games all year as well as us. So we knew we was going to be in a dumb fight. Mm-hmm. Me and Coach Tree, I always looked up to him. He's like a big brother to me. But we all know for those 2 hours that we got go against each other, it's going to be war. And then right afterwards, we hug before the game. Mm-hmm. It's a war for the 2 hours. Mm-hmm. Then right after the game, we back man friends. Mm-hmm. I respect them a lot. Like I said, but the kids, my hat goes off to them because they got down early. They fought. We made some adjustments at halftime, and then the kids came out and they sold on both ends of the floor. We was fortunate to win.
Yeah, Darnell Dantzler's Emerson Red Storm team was down by as many as, I think, 8-9 points in that first half. They just chipped away. Actually, down by 10 late in the first half, but they chipped away. It was tied 51-51 in the fourth quarter where the Red Storm finally gets the win, 73-67. The moving position, still got some work to do, but they are now in favorable position to get to the city title game. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Toney.